Darling, you send me, I know you.
Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Alexandra, but you can call me Ale, okay? Call me Ale. Where we love everything thrifted and obviously DIY. So in this episode, it's so exciting because I'm gonna take you guys to my phone, specifically to my Pinterest, where I have pinned a lot of stuff that I really would like to DIY, but because cane is super expensive, $120 for I don't know what the measurements really exactly are. I looked it up in Etsy and I didn't put much attention, but $122, girl, no, thank you. So I went on a mission to go to the dollar store and try to find something that I could put together so that it looks like cane. And honestly, it didn't went too bad. Okay, right here you see me going to my apps craft pin that I have saved. And this is all the ideas I was storing, and I'm really getting inspired by this cane natural looking in that book storage unit. And I also got inspired by this jewelry holder. I just love the natural look. So you grab these reeds, metallic reeds from the dollar store. You take the spikes off. And then you get the non-slip rug. You paint it with your favorite color that you have. I painted mine with a brand of Walmart that is basically like a natural color. The naturalest color that I could find. Once it's dried, you cut it, you make it off center so that it gives it more the idea of cane, because if you put it just like in the same pattern, it's not gonna make like a lot of sense. So you have to put it off spaced so that it looks more like cane. And then you start cutting everything to make the sewing, because I used sewing much easier without all this material in your way. And then yeah, you just see me here sewing, and I just sew around the whole thing. It's very easy to do. It's nothing too major, like whoever can make this, because you don't need to know how to sew exactly to make this happen. You just have to make sure it just stays put together with the thread, or if you have any like other ideas that you can use to keep it together, then you can use that. I'm just giving you like the idea of what you can and can't do. So right here, just cut off your excess, and here you have it, a cute, two cute jewelry holders that you're gonna be able to put together. So what do you guys think about the jewelry holders and the idea that I had with the non-slippery rug cane idea that I had? Like, honestly, you guys have to let me know. I really hope that you guys like it, and on to the next one. So right here, you just grab a shadow box, paint it whatever color you want to paint it. You grab a stick if you have it. I didn't have one stick put together, so I had to improvise, and then I put it together with hot glue, and then I put the rug, I cut it to size, I off-centered it so it can make it look more like natural cane. I used the stapling method. I mean, if you have any other ideas on how to do it and that is gonna be way easier for you to do, that's fine. I'm just here to give you the inside, I guess, of what I made, and then cut it to size. And yeah, there you have it. Very cane looking book holder. this one has to be my most favorite project that I made just because it looks very, very real. It looked like real Kane in person. I know the video doesn't really make any justice to it, but honestly, believe me, it does look like legit Kane. One thing that I would do though, that I highly recommend for you to do, is measure your kids' books beforehand, okay? That is one thing. Because if you do it like I did and just like grab one that looked okay to you, then you're probably gonna make the same mistake and probably your kids' books, not all of them are gonna fit in them. So yeah. And another tip is that if you can build your own frame so that is like by your liking thick, so that thicker books can go into it, and that would be super good. I'm honestly gonna be building another one because that one is just too small, and since I put that one in my daughter's room, I'm thinking I'm gonna put that in the living room with the remotes because it's so like compact and little and so cute, and obviously I don't want to get rid of it. I'm gonna make another one for her room, and I'm actually gonna do that with 2x4 pieces of wood, and then I'm gonna put the lining on, yeah, the back of it so that it still looks like Kane, but a bigger version of it so I can fit more books because she does have more books. I just couldn't fill that one and it was kind of sad, but it's okay because I already know how to get that Kane look from the dollar store that everybody's gonna like. Okay, on to the next one. Okay, this is my final project, and this is pretty much what was left from the other two projects. I cut it in half and then I grabbed a base. I wrapped that around it, cut the excess, and then tried to do my best to off-center it so it looks more like Kane. Is you guys, it's time to decide which one was your favorite. This one that I just made was so easy. I didn't even need hot glue or nothing because since it's a non-slippery rug, it's very sticky and the paint makes it even stickier. And I didn't need anything. So if I wanted to remove it and use it for something else, I can. So it's everything about repurposing, girl. Alright you guys, so thank you so much for watching. I really hope you guys liked it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you did. Give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if there's anything that you guys would like me to recreate. And don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, ecologicalvintage.shop. Thank you. Bye. Till next time.